Lorna, how's it going? All right, so you asked for a twin flame reading. So I'm going to be using the John Holland tarot for that. And I'm going to do a crystal ball reading on top of it. So if I need to clarify the John Holland, I will use my Osho Zen here. All right. So let me just give these guys a quick shuffle. Cards that fell out is two wands, king of pentacles, and seven of wands. So seeing things from a higher perspective, grounding your masculine in the 3D, making it a reality, but it's causing stress. Or the bubble is about to burst. Okay, so beginning with your recent past position, solitude, the hermit. Feminine energy, you've withdrawn from society and conditioning and the material world in search of your higher self, your higher purpose, your truth. Masculine, nice, heart chakra, lit the fuck up, that's awesome. So he's really stepped into unconditional love, allowing love to come in and giving it as well. Your present position, Three of Cups, union, celebrating the feeling of true love, unconditional love. You feel union is near, and it's exciting you. Transformation from the masculine, present position. So he is letting go of his old life, his, the ego identities, the falseness of the 3D world. And it's a rebirth, from the chrysalis. It's living your truest purpose. And so he's growing, butterfly wings, or I should say, shedding his skin, letting it all fall away, transforming into something new, his truth. Your near future, Seven of Cups, not seeing things clearly, confusion, not knowing which way to turn. And so Source is asking you to look within you, and you have the answer. Just follow your heart. So I'm going to pull a clarifier for that. Tower. So the tower is a sudden energy, comes in out of the blue. It strikes down all the falsehood, the lies. It brings your faulty foundation to the ground in order for new to be reborn from it. And spirit is asking you to be the conscious observer behind the tower. Allow the tower to fall. So there's confusion because this confusion is a result of the tower and his transformation. So, when this tower does come, just relax into it and allow and follow your heart. Near future masculine, wow, wish granted. Nine of Cups, it is abundance of love. It is an arrival at that place of celebrating love, abundance of love. But more importantly, it is your wish granted. So he's moving towards his heart, making his dreams a reality, being reborn. Final outcome. Four of Pentacles, so a firm foundation is grounded in 3D. As a result of the tower coming down, the seed is planted and growth is assured. So a strong foundation results from the tower. Although there may be some confusion in the near future, ultimately it is to allow this new beginning. Outcome for the masculine? Nice. Authorita. Stepping into his divine masculine. Heart chakra open. His being reborn from love. Following his heart. And making it a reality. The four is that firm foundation, that strength that comes from the emperor, the leader. Okay, so what are you bringing into the union? Three of Wands, partnerships and alliances. You're reaching out to help this dream become a reality. It's two people coming together in order to share a common goal that is based on your spiritual knowing, your true higher self. So you're reaching out, allowing space for him to reach back. What is he bringing in? Nine of Swords, suffering in silence. So currently he is going through that massive transformation, and it's coming to an end now. The nine means completion, and he got two nines, two fours and two nines. Actually, three fours and two nines. That's crazy. And you got a four as well on your side, but most of your cards are threes. Oh, you got a nine as well with the Hermit. So fours is grounding energy, and nine is completion. So he's coming out of this state. He's looking towards the sun, towards the light. The Nine of Swords is, you know, feeling trapped, consumed by thoughts, fears, anxiety, stress, just overwhelming fear, darkness, dark night of the soul. But from that, you are reborn into your truth, into your truer, higher calling. So although it is a difficult stage for him to go through, it is, you know, his path is, he's on the right path is what I'm trying to say. Okay, foundation, Four of Cups. This is a shared energy between the two of you. Feeling like things aren't moving forward fast enough. Feeling disconnected, longing, wanting union. Crown energy, truth, course, judgment, grand awakening. Realizing your entire life has just been a dream played on a, you know, a screen in your own mind. None of it is real. So there's an awakening, an evolution of consciousness that you both share as a crowning energy. Awakening to your true calling, your true destiny. All right, so let me just move these over a little bit, and I'm going to do the crystal ball for you. Oh, actually, I wanted to look at the bottom of the deck as well for the overall energy of this twin flame. Nice. Wish granted. Star card. So this is your wish fulfilled again. You wish upon a star, and it is now being realized as an overall message, energy from the reading. So this card comes after a very difficult period of time, and it's a healing energy, time of rest and rejuvenation. So like I said, it's shared, so you both see each other as that star in the sky, your ultimate destiny and dream. And you both hold each other very lovingly, and you desire to be one. And it's a result of this awakening to your truth. All right, one more quick shuffle. So, 5x5 grid, distant past, recent past, present, near future, and future. There's going to be four cards that represent the main energy of the reading, and then one center card that represents the main message from the universe, the core issue. Beginning with the first cornerstone card, distant past position, nine of swords again, same card that is being brought into the union. So again, it's a feeling of being trapped, anxiety, fear, dark night of the soul, but it's a nine, which means it's nearing the completion. Okay, next. Seven of Pentacles, waiting, patience. It's laying the foundation for a future together in the 3D. It's putting a lot of work into that, and now you're waiting for that ship to return. You're waiting for the payoff. So usually this card indicates that the wait is almost over. Six of Wands, success and victory. The wand energy is fire, which is spirit. So you're being recognized as being spiritually awakened, illuminated, and that, you know, harvest or that rewards is coming towards you. And it's beautiful that it's right beside the Seven of Pentacles. That is what you're waiting for in the distant past. You're waiting for that return. Ace of Cups. Brand new beginning of love. Feeling pure, unconditional love. Letting go of the past pain. And forgiving yourself and others. Healing yourself in order to be truly open to giving and receiving love. The cornerstone card. Five of Cups. Feeling emotional loss. Feeling disconnected from someone that you love very dearly. It's mourning, pain. So notice that the two cornerstone cards, it's kind of a masculine energy is what I'm picking up from the two. And in the center is this success, this patience and love. So it's like you are balancing this negative energy in order to allow this new beginning. So I'm feeling, you know, that healing has taken place in the past. Pain has been let go with you. You've done the healing and you're sitting patiently, but the masculine has some final things that he needs to release. Okay, recent past position, Queen of Cups, could represent a water sign, but this is you being that open vessel, that channel to allow love to come in. It's unconditional love. You are being recognized as being intuitive, psychic, just connected to your higher self and in a space of peace and love. And it's right below the Nine of Swords. So there's healing that's coming from that anxiety and that stress. Wheel of Fortune, significant change is taking place in your environment. What goes around comes around. And what's coming back is good fortune and good luck and a completion of a cycle. And it will turn out in your favor. So that thing that you're waiting for becomes like creates change in your recent past. And it has to do with love. Four of Swords. So it's retreating from negative thinking, negative people, calming your mind, finding peace and solitude, and healing your heart, letting go, in order to ground a new beginning in the reality, in the 3D. Seven of Cups again, feeling lost and confused, not seeing your way clearly. And again, Spirit is asking you to follow your heart. So it's right beside the Four of Swords, which means that, you know, this healing that took place in the recent past because of confusion, related to the Ace of Cups, that new beginning, not seeing your direction clearly. There's a haze which caused pain and a disconnect. Magician, number one, the master manifester, making your dreams a reality. So because of this completion of the cycle, and because your heart is open and receptive, it allowed for some healing and peaceful energy to give clarity. The magician shapes his reality. He realizes that it is just a dream manifested or created in your mind, and here you get to shape your own reality. Choose your environment. Choose how you would like to live your life. Present position. Four cups again. Disconnect. You're feeling things aren't moving fast enough. Remember, that was the foundation energy, that shared energy between the two of you. Longing, wanting union, and feeling like nothing's happening. Feeling, emotional disconnect. So it's right below the Queen of Cups here, which is, and this energy is looking towards the past, towards, looking out the window, longing for this connection with the Queen. Three of Swords, heartbreak. So this disconnect is causing pain. Could be coming from either one of you, but it is stopping this wheel of fortune, this good fortune, from coming forward completely. This next card represents 0 point, main message from the universe for the both of you. Nine of Pentacles. Beautiful. Grounded energy. This is the fruit being ripe, ready to fall from the branch. It is harvest. It is an arrival, a completion in the 3D world. It is feeling independent and financially, financial abundance. Next, Six of Cups, reunion. Somebody that you've loved very dearly in the past, someone you had a connection with, comes back, returns. So this is a pure love, innocent, and a return to your child within. Two of Pentacles, the wind of change. And it's a uneasy feeling. It's needing to make a decision about your 3D life. And it's causing chaos, but what Spirit is asking you to do is to be resilient, bend with the winds, go with the flow, allow the change to happen without any interference from you. So this comes below the Magician card. So in the recent past, there was a decision to allow this Wheel of Fortune to change your life, but it required a retreat and clarity. So there's that new beginning that is being manifested by the Magician, and is the result of a decision that needs to be made currently in the present. And it has to do with somebody that you love very dearly in the past. But there's a sense that independence is required, and because there isn't complete independence, it is causing longing and heartbreak. So a disconnect is required, even though you want that reconnection with your masculine. The only way to fully allow that love to come through is to completely disconnect find your freedom, independence, and look after yourself. You are ready to start a new life in the 3D, but there's still this lingering pain that needs to be released. Near future, Knight of Pentacles, my favorite knight. He arrives, guaranteed. He makes a very long strategic plan, and he carries that plan out one step at a time. So usually when this card shows up, it means that the knight is about to arrive in the 3D. Seven of Wands, speaking up, standing up for yourself, never giving up, never surrendering, expressing your core beliefs, your desires. So there's a sense that strength results from this Three of Swords. Allowing that pain to be released opens that gate for the Knight of Pentacles to come through. And it's because it's your higher destiny, your higher calling. Wands is spirit. King of Air, King of Swords. So this could represent an air sign. So this is someone who has mental clarity. He speaks his truth, knows his truth, the pinnacle of truth. It is also communication that is detached from any emotional bullshit. But he is mental clarity, and he is expressing his truth, standing in his power, and grounding his dreams into reality, just like the magician. Six of Swords, moving on, letting go of the past, negative people, negative situations, and finally moving towards calmer waters. I love this card because it is an absolute cutoff. That's it, no more. I'm living my life the way I want to live it. And that's what the King brings. He brings mental clarity, truth. He carries the sword of truth, cuts the barriers away. Next, Ten of Swords. Perfect. Perfect. Remember, there are Nine of Swords, corner card, pain, loss, regret, causing a delay. And here we have in the near future, Ten of Swords, cutting that completely off. No more. It is the end, completion. Ten returns to one, which is a new beginning. So this is the sword that the King brings with him. Cornerstone card, final row, Seven of Swords. So this Seven of Swords is a lingering energy from the Four of Cups and the Nine of Swords. So the Nine of Swords is feeling like you're in that mental prison. You can't move, causing anxiety and stress, which created that sense of longing and disconnect, which ultimately will create a sense of being deceived, lied to. Is this real? It's not having all the answers, but just feeling like somebody's sneaking around behind your back is going to hurt you. So, yeah, this energy needs to be released. It's a cornerstone card. Hangman. Spirit is asking you to let go of control, surrender, see things from a different perspective. So it is an awakening to this energy, awakening to your truth, your inner knowing, and surrendering to it. So it's a complete perspective change. You see how this energy is looking towards, you know, looking over his shoulder. Same with this energy, looking over the shoulder, expecting the worst, but there is a release, an awakening. Three of Pentacles. Remember, you got the Four of Pentacles in your near future position. So this is that grounded reality. It is foundation solidly planted as a result of changing that perspective, allowing that King of Pentacles, King of Air, to come forward and ground, be grounded in reality as a result of cutting away negative. Next, King of Cups. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. So remember, you got the Queen of Cups over there. You are an open vessel, allowing this transformation, allowing the masculine to go through this process and allow his fears to be cut away on his own. You allowed that space to happen, and now he comes to you, returns to you. Heart chakra open, the divine masculine as the King of Cups, King of Love, pure, innocent, open, free, love. Final cornerstone card. Oh my God. Spiritual union, Two of Cups. Wow. That is amazing. Wish granted, girlfriend. This is recognizing your twin flame and actually coming into union on a spiritual level. Recognizing your reflection, your true love. He brings with this grounding energy, this new perspective. He's bringing his heart with him as an offering to you in the near future, or in the distant future. That is so perfect. I almost want to cry. I'm jelly. That's beautiful. Okay. So now I'm going to use Call Up Bear and Read. I'm going to pull two cards from Message from the Universe, starting with the feminine first. What messages do you have for Lorna? Gentle Gardener, Stormfields. And I'm really picking up that Gentle Gardener energy from you for sure in the reading. Okay. Be your own person. Be a conscious co-creator. The Gentle Gardener is visiting you at this moment in your life to remind you that your thoughts, feelings, and beliefs create the reality you experience. She is the embodiment of energy within you that is sent out into the field of co-creation, ensures that all that you are is reflected in the world of form. Are you aware of your thoughts? What are their quality? Believe in limitless possibility, and you will see miracles unfold. The Gentle Gardener guarantees the integrity of everything you send out into the world. Stay positive and expect a wondrous return. Your garden is abundant with beauty. And you got Stormfields. This too shall pass. An uncomfortable chaos is surrounding you. Things that you've left unattended may be the cause of conflict. Pent-up energy needs to be released, just as a storm in nature must break for these events to occur. When the electricity between opposing forces stirs things up and creates temporary disorder. Not all storms are destructive. Rather, they serve nature by bringing rain to the ground and wind to the tree, enabling seeds to be widely distributed and continuous growth to be ensured. Just remember that whatever is being stirred up inside of you or between you and another will benefit you later. The sun will shine again and new growth will be observed. Don't be afraid to shake things up a little. And that's exactly what I'm getting from him. He's ready to shake shit up. Okay, so what I'm seeing is mostly masculine energy here that is going through that transformation. And although it's causing confusion for you, you know what you want. You know your truth. You're grounding this union in reality. Center card is Nine of Pentacles. Feminine energy. Grounding union. Allowing this love to happen. And it will happen, my friend. All right. I hope this helped. Much love to you.